A picture may be worth a thousand words, but some are worth millions of dollars, depending on the picture, of course.
An upstate man believes he is sitting on a gold mine with a rare photo of Billy the Kid, the famous Western outlaw. But proving it's a photo of the real William Bonney hasn't been so easy. So tonight, we will let you decide. News 4's Tim Waller is looking out for you with a Billy the Kid mystery that began on eBay.
And he really bought it on eBay?
Yeah, for $9.99. Huh? And I know what you're thinking. How could a picture of somebody bought on eBay for 10 bucks be Billy the Kid, right? Well, Justin Shaw has an eye for this sort of thing, as you're about to see. Plus, he's not the only person who believes this 1800s tintype depicts the real Billy.
Reap the whirlwind, Sheriff Brady. Reap it.
We don't need to explain who Billy the Kid was. Nearly 50 movies have been made about the legendary outlaw.
And I sure would like to touch the gun that's going to kill Billy the Kid.
And we know what the real Billy the Kid looked like, thanks to this tintype from the 1800s. It's the only authenticated photo of William Bonney, and it sold at auction this year for $2.3 million.
He has a very, very distinct face.
But Justin Shaw of Spartanburg believes he owns another Billy the Kid tintype.
Once you find so many similarities, you're past the point of no return. There's no one else that it can possibly be.
Shaw found the photo on eBay. It was an auction for an antique tintype of two young, well-dressed men. Neither man appears to resemble Billy the Kid, at least the rough-cut outlaw of legend. But Shaw couldn't take his eyes off one of them.
If you look at the known image, the authenticated image, having seen that image a thousand times, I knew it was, to me, it was just like instantaneous. I said, that has to be Billy the Kid.
He's talking about the man who is seated in this picture, who is far more clean-cut than the man in the authenticated photo. But Shaw says the two men are one and the same, and he bases that on the tiniest of details.
When the eyebrows match up perfectly, when the distance of the eyes match up perfectly, the length of the nose, this nostril is bigger than the other nostril, just like that nostril is bigger than the other nostril. And in addition, he's wearing the hat the exact same way, and he's holding his head the exact same way.
The more similarities Shaw points out, the more you begin to see a resemblance. But if you're still not convinced the man in Shaw's photo is Billy the Kid...
The way we compare images is by normalizing two faces.
Consider this video in which facial recognition expert Robert Schmidt compares the known image of Bonney to Shaw's image.
In this case, we'll mark the eyes of the old photo of Billy the Kid. Then we'll take the picture from the photograph that you have and we'll mark the eyes. Then we'll do a comparison of the two pictures.
The results are astounding, to say the least.
And you can see how the features line up almost exactly. The mouth, the nose, the ears, and in fact, the nose looks so similar that it's startling.
And watch what happens when he places one photo on top of the other and blends the two images together.
Watch the nose as it goes from one nose into the other. It's almost identical. Watch the mouth. You can see how the mouth moves from one photo to another and becomes almost exactly the same.
Schmidt later told News 4 the men in the photos are the same person, no question about it. But Shaw says no one in the collector's world will take his image seriously because of something he doesn't have.
Provenance. Provenance and a clear line of descent.
Because he bought the tintype on eBay, because the seller doesn't know who owned it originally, it's impossible to establish provenance, the item's history of ownership.
Apparently, to historical Western collectors, you have to have a rock-solid story that goes behind the image in order for the image to be authenticated.
This is a painting that's been quite in demand over the last few years.
But it's not just tintypes from the 1800s that require provenance in order to be authenticated. In the art world, provenance means everything to collectors and curators like John Nolan of the Bob Jones University Museum and Gallery.
Provenance is as important as maybe the value it can add to your piece. Just maybe value historically, value monetarily.
Take, for example, the painting over Nolan's right shoulder. It was valuable to begin with based on age and other factors, but its provenance was circumstantial at best. After months of research, Nolan was able to trace the painting to its original owners, Napoleon and Josephine. And guess what that did to the painting's value?
The value definitely has gone up.
But no amount of detective work can establish the history of ownership for Shaw's tintype.
Does that bug you? Does that bother you?
Oh, it's I have lost sleep at night trying to figure out a way to establish a rock-solid provenance.
And strangely enough, the way that he wears his hat, slightly cocked to one side, is also the same.
Shaw believes his high-tech analysis should be enough to prove this is the real William Bonney.
I'm 125% convinced. There is no one else in this world that it could possibly be.
And that is just one battle Justin Shaw is fighting. He also claims to have an original photo of John Wesley Hardin, another famous Western outlaw. Plus, he has photos of Doc Holliday, Wyatt Earp, Frank and Jesse James, Bat Masterson, and the Clanton brothers from the gunfight at the OK Corral. But these are all photos he bought on eBay, and just like that photo of Billy the Kid, none of them can actually be authenticated.
Quite a collector there, Tim. Okay, so what exactly does Shaw want?
I think he wants a couple of things. First of all, he wants people in the Western memorabilia collector's world to acknowledge that he just might have the real thing. And also, he's kind of looking for that big payday. I mean, the one photo, the authenticated photo, sold for $2.3
million. I mentioned this during the story. Isn't it possible that this person that he has a picture of could be a relative or someone different?
It is possible, says Robert Schmidt, the facial recognition expert, but he says it's highly unlikely. He says the two photos are a perfect match according to that forensic program you saw there. And unless Billy the Kid had a twin brother, the gene pool, Schmidt says, just isn't that large, particularly all the way back in the 1800s.